Hello, welcome to session number 3 in the series Embedded System Design. My name is Anurag Nigam and we are talking about GPIOs of AVR controller. And what we have with us is this Arduino Pro Mini, and we were exploring the GPIO port D. So what I have written over here, you can see, is that I'm complementing or one's complement of whatever I'm displaying. So that's why all the LEDs are blinking. Right now, if I want to put these LEDs in a ring configuration, right, so I am going to use one more operator which we have discussed, which is the shift operator. So now if I shift it to the left, right, so I have to check when it runs out of the bits one, and then I have to basically reset the word. So for that, if I say if this is equal to zero, right, so if this is equal to zero, then I am going to set the this to 0 1. So at least we have one bit which is one, so that we can shift it around. And whenever, you know, this becomes zero, that is the one has passed out from MSB and we are doing a left shift, it will be zero, and then any amount of shifting will not cause one to reappear in the word. So for one to be there, whenever this becomes zero, set it to 0 1. And then what you can do here is, so if this becomes that, else what you're going to do is this, and I'm going to move it to the left by one bit, right? So this is very simple. Now here I'm going to change the comment, okay, so that, you know, it is representative of what I've written here. And it is saying that reset this or shift by a bit to left. So this is reset this on 0x00 or shift left by one bit. So that's what this is doing, right? And if I was to go here, project, and say configure, and I'm going to make sure that it is going to be uploaded to Pro Mini, so that's fine. So if I do a build all, so if I go to project and build all, so I'm going to program the chip. And now you can see what this is doing. Let me just put it on full screen. Okay, so now you can see that the bits are shifted one by one to the left, and when you go, when this goes out from here, then I have to set that to 0 1, right? And then again it starts shifting. So this is a very simple example of left shift of a bit. And I can also run a binary counter. So for running a binary counter, I have to do very simple stuff here, because here the overflow is going to take care of resetting. So I don't have to do a if statement. I have to just say this plus plus, right? And here that, and I'm going to delete all this stuff, right? And here the comment would be, so I'm going to move this below, so that the first one is 0 0, that is covered, right? So I'm going to move it over here, enter, and probably I should also move the comment. So first it's going to start with 0, right? And then it is going to increment the counter by 1. So this is going to be counting. Okay, so I will call this as count update. So that's what it is doing. So if I burn this, now you can see. So just one second. Let me see, I'm on a wrong screen. Okay, so let's put you back onto the main screen. Okay, so here, what I have done is, instead of, you know, shifting it to the left bitwise, I'm just doing an increment operator. Okay, so that's going to increase the binary counter. So it starts with 0, And then it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 like that in binary. And you will see over here, instead of just going like a ring, right, it'll go like a binary count. So let's just build this project. Say build all. Okay, and say program chip. And I'm going to put the other screen function. Yeah, so here you'll see this is bit 1, bit 2, bit 3, bit 4, up to bit 0 to bit 7, right? So you see this is binary count here, right? So this is up counting by 1. Now there's not much fun in this because you have written this in a while loop, right? So what I want to do is I want to use these buttons. Okay, one button is for increment, other button is for decrement, and I will show you a bad way of writing it and a good way of writing it. The bad way of writing is port B. So you are in the while loop, you are polling point B, and whenever you encounter a button press, you are going to update, or you are going to up the count by 1, or you are going to down the count by 1. Okay, so let's do the bad way first. Okay, so let's see, let me go back to my code. Okay, so to go back to my code, here we are. So what I want to do is I'm going to set port B as the input port, which by default is input port only, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say if, and then I'm going to read pin B. Okay, so this is going to be reading port B, right? And if pin B, and then that I'm going to do an AND with 0x 3. So I'm letting the mask on the first two bits, right? So rest of the bits will be set to 0, right? And then if this thing which I read from port B or pin B is equal to let's say 0x01, which means that the first button is pressed, okay, on port on PB0 is pressed, right? Then I am going to say plus plus this. Okay, so that's the end of the statement. Okay, and then if, okay, but now the problem here is how many times the interrupt is how many times it's going to read. It's going to read multiple times, right? So it's going to very quickly count all the times it has read, right? So what I want to do here is, instead of putting delay here, I want to so this one basically is going to be the way this has been hooked up. So let's see how it has been hooked up. Okay, okay, so the way this is hooked up on this board is the following. Okay, so there is a port. So of course, now you see, if you press a button, that value will go to 0, right? So if the first button is pressed, then the word read will be 02, right? So first button will be 02. So I'll cause this to 02, and then I am going to increment this, but I'm going to put this in a bracket, and here I am going to say put a delay to avoid any further read Okay, and delay in milliseconds. Okay, and let's put that delay to something like 40 or 50 millisecond or 30 millisecond. So what's going to happen is you have to release the button in 30 milliseconds. So that's too little a time, right? So how about let's put in a delay of 500. Okay, and then so it is going to increment this on that button press, right? And then if so, this is not a good way of doing this. Okay, so I'm telling you in advance, this is not a good way of doing this, but still, people do it, so I'm just showing it. If pin B and with 0x03 and is equal to 0x01, right? Okay, so if this is true, then do something which will be decrement this. So I'm going to copy the same stuff. Control C, Control V. Okay. So now you may say, why is this 500 millisecond there? Right. This is because, so this is no counter running, so let's get rid of that. Okay. So this is because whenever you keep it pressed, it's going to read it very fast because it's in the while loop, right? And if you keep it pressed for a certain duration, you have to avoid it reading it again and again. So you have to release it in 500 milliseconds, right? So let's see if this is going to work. So if pin B ended with 03 is 02, then increment it, else decrement it, right? So first button, which is this one, the lower button is going to increment, the higher button is going to decrement. So let's see if this works. I'm not sure myself. Okay, program the chip. So right now it's doing nothing. So if I press this one, it decremented by one. So from 00 it went to FF. Now this one is increment. So if I press this one, it incremented 00. Then, so let me put this on a full screen so that you can see clearly what happened. Function 12. Okay, so what I was saying was, this is the increment button. This is the increment button. This is the decrement. So I'm not sure which one is what. So let's press this one. Okay, so this increments it by one. So 0 became 1. Okay, then if I press again, it became 2, right? And then it became 3. And then if I press it again, it became 4, and then 5, and then 6, and then 7, and then the fourth bit is 8, and then 9, then 10, then 11, then 12, then 13, then 14, and then 15. And then it'll become 1F, right? So it'll become, this is F, so it'll become 10. So now it's 10. Then again, it's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So this is 1F. Now it'll become 2, right? So basically, this button press is on polling. Right, and if I was to press the lower button, it's going to decrement, so I'll go the reverse way. So now this has become 1F, has become 1F. Okay, then this is 1E, right? Then this is 1D, okay, 1C, and then this one is going to be 1B, 1A, then this is going to be 19, 18. 17, 16, 15, 1-4, 1-3, 1-2, 1-1, and then it is going to become, after 1-1, it is going to become 1-0, then F, right? Then FE, then D, then after D, it's going to be C, then this is B, this is A, this is 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then 0. So we have implemented a increment and a decrement, which is working on polling port B. Now, this is a very bad way of doing this, because your processor in the main thread is always checking port B, wasting the resources and time. So the good way of doing this is going to be an interrupt. So what I'm going to show you next is to do the same thing using pin change interrupt. Okay, so because the interrupt 0 and 1, they are already taken. Okay, why they are taken? Because if you go to the connection, okay, if you go to the connection and look for these ports, right, PD0 to PD7, this is already going to LEDs, right? So it's not that you cannot receive the interrupt, but I haven't connected the switch to the interrupt 0 and 1. So the interrupt 0 is coming on PD2, and interrupt 1 is coming on PD3, which is already reserved for the LED connection, right? So let me see if you are seeing what I'm seeing. Okay, you are not seeing what I'm seeing. Okay, let me put back to the main screen. Okay, so what I was saying was I could have used interrupt 0 or interrupt 1. So interrupt 0 is PD2 and interrupt 1 is PD3. Now they are already taken by the LEDs over here, right? So I could have still issued an interrupt on a configured pin. I could have put a switch there, but then of course the interrupt has a higher precedence on, you know, port output or input, so that's going to work. But then unnecessarily one of the LEDs will light up, or you know, they will be, you know, switching off. So you don't want to see that. So I'm not going to use interrupt 0 and 1. I am going to use pin change interrupt. So it says PC into 0 here, PC into 1. So these switches are on PB0 and PB1. Now if they are in PB0 and PB1, I should be able to use pin change interrupt to cause these LEDs to up the counter or down the counter, right? Now to do that, you have to set some of the registers. Okay, so the first register I'm going to talk about is called PCICR, pin change interrupt control register. Here I'll tell you there are three banks. Initially I told you there are three banks: PCIe0, PCIe1, PCIe2. So basically for that there are going to be three interrupt vectors inside this header file. You can see there are three interrupt vectors here. Okay, so I'm going to just teach you how to write an interrupt. Okay, so PC int 0, PC int 1, PC int 2. Okay, so these are the three interrupt vectors corresponding to three interrupt banks, and these three interrupt banks are, okay, interrupt PC interrupt 0, 1 and 2. So if I was to use PC, so if I was to go into details of this, there is a mask register here. Okay, so this is a flag register. Next is the mask register. So if this mask register, if I use PC interrupt 2 bank, then the corresponding mask register is PCMSK2. And the interrupts which can be issued are PC in 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16. Right? And if I look at the diagram, so this PC 23 is over here, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, okay, 17, 16. Okay, so they are on the port D, one of the pins of port D. So PC interrupt 23 to 16 are over here. So if I go to bank 2, I'm seeing PC interrupt 14 to 8. So PC interrupt 14 to 8 in the diagram. Okay, PC interrupt 14 to 8 would be over here, which is in port C. 14, okay, then 13 is somewhere else. Okay, 12, 11, 11 I can see, 10, 9, 8 I can see. Okay, so this is in bank 2. So the ones which you don't see is going to be these four pins over here, which means that these are going to be, so if I was to show you where they are, which are not listed here, they are not listed because in the back side, so they are listed here, PC interrupt 13, 12, which is on PC 5 and PC 4, okay, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, so these are in port C. Okay, now we are having switches on port B. So this says that this is PC interrupt 0 and 1. So if I go to here, I see the master register 0. Okay, so here I can see PC interrupt 7654 3210, which corresponds to pins which are here. Okay, PC interrupt 0 in PB0, PC interrupt 1 is in PB1, and then you have PC interrupt 2 3 4 5. Okay, and then there should be 6 and 7. So where is 6 and 7? Okay, so that basically should be going to pin 19 and 22. I think so. 6 and 7 should be there. Okay, but anyways, so our switch is on PC interrupt 0 and PC interrupt 1 pins, which is PB0 and PB1. So here is our switch connected. Right, so if you see here in the connections, okay, so our switch is connected to PB0 and PB1, which means that I'm working with PC interrupt 0 and PC interrupt 1. So that means that my master register is going to be PC MSK 0, and the bank is going to be PC interrupt the control register. The bank is going to be PC interrupt, not this is a flag register. Okay, it's going to be PCICR, going to be the LSB here to enable it. So PC interrupt control register is to enable one of the banks first, and then you are going to use the mask to mask out all the other interrupts other than PB0 and PB1, right? So we are going to use mask 0. So these are the two registers which you have to set. Okay, so let's do that. And again, I have also showed you that the interrupt vector is going to be, so if you go here, if you look into interrupt vector, you will see it is PCINT0, which I have to use, and PCINT1 and PCINT2 is there, right? So we are in the bank 0. So I am going to go here and first write the interrupt routine. Okay, so what I'll do here is I am going to create, because this is a pin change interrupt. Again, the problem is unless there is a change, okay, that interrupt should not have any meaning for us, right? So I have to compare it to my previous values. Okay, so I'm going to create two more variables, which is I'm going to call volatile unsigned character, and this is pins, and then volatile unsigned character pins. Okay, here is what I'm going to read. Okay, so now following that, I can write the interrupt routine. So the way I will write the interrupt routine is interrupt followed by the vector, and the vector is going to be 4, or I can say alias is PC_INT0. So I can write here PC_INT0. So that's the vector, and then I'm going to say it is going to return a void, and this is going to be update disp. Okay, so this is the function which I'm calling, and it is going to receive a void and it is going to do something. So whenever the interrupt comes, this function is going to be executed, right? So in that case, what do I have to do? I have to first check, okay, pins. So I am reading port B. Pins is equal to pin B, okay, and with. So this is basically I'm masking, right? And with. So initially this is a global variable, both will be zero, both will be same, okay? So now I'm going to end with 0x03, which means I'm looking at two bits of port B, which is PB0 and PB1, and then I'm going to say if pins is not equal to, okay, pins, or I can say pins not equal to prev, okay, pins not equal to previous pins, okay, that means that the pin change occurred, right? Then I'm supposed to do something, okay? Now what that thing is going to be, very simple. If pins equal to 0x02, right, then what I'm going to do, I am going to update plus plus this, okay? So that's my first statement. If pins is equal to 0x01, right, and then I'm going to say minus minus this, okay, and at the end I would say previous pins is equal to pins when I exit out of this. So now in essence I have written this routine in the while loop, which I have written here with the delay and all that, okay? I have written that in the interrupt routine, okay? So I am going to just delete that. Okay, this is delete. Okay, so now my main has become very simplified here, right? Okay, now but I have to enable this interrupt routine, right? So the first thing is the control register, okay? So if I go to the control register, it is called PCICR, okay? So I have to go here and set PCICR, right? Okay, which I will add over here. PCICR should be equal to 0x01, which means that I have enabled bank 1. So I have enabled bank 0 of pin change interrupt. Pin change interrupt, right? So that's that. And then I have to set a mask. Okay, so I will say mask 0, right? So that mask 0 is going to be PCMSK0, right? PCMSK0. So that's this one. And I have to mask out all the bits except this. So I have to set these two as 1. So this will be 3 actually, right? 0, 3. So PCMSK0 is going to be 03. So just 1 second. So here I can say PCMSK0 is going to be equal to 0x03. So I have set my control register. So I am putting unmask PB0. And PB1, or you can say PC int 0 and PC int 1. So I have unmasked that, other bits are masked, right? So I'm ready to receive the interrupts. So when I receive the interrupt, right, it is going to go here into the interrupt routine and say that read whatever is on pin B, which can be 0, 1, or it can be a 02. So if you do a 02, then you are going to update by, you know, adding 1 to it. And if it is 01, I am going to update by decrementing by 1, right? And but again, in the pin change interrupt, I am checking if there is really a pin change, okay? So that if pins is not equal to pins previous, that means that there is a change, and then I'm going to do this. And whatever is the last value of pins, I'm going to put that in the previous pins. Okay, so this is very simple. I am just doing that. But before I do anything, okay, what I have to do here is, so it will start with everything as blank, right? Because that port D is equal to this, and this is a global variable which is initialized to zero by default. Here I have to enable the global interrupt variable, which is under MCUCR, I think. Okay, so what I have to do here is I have to issue a director to assembler, ASM, and that would be set enable interrupt. So this is all small. Okay, and because this is a preprocessor directive, there is no semicolon. So I have enabled the global interrupt flag by doing issuing a assembly instruction, SCI, set interrupt, set enable interrupt. Okay, similarly, SEI, SLI, CLI, clear interrupt, SEI, set interrupt. Okay, so SEI is going to set the interrupts. So it is going to enable all the interrupts on the processor. And CLI would disable all the interrupts. And one of the interrupts is a pin change interrupt. For that, PCICR is the control word, which says check for interrupts on bank 0. And in bank 0, read the two bits, which is PB0 and PB1, or PCINT 0 and 1 for receiving the interrupt. So you put appropriate mask. And then you write an interrupt routine, which says interrupt this vector and void update display. And then that's what you are doing. So let's see if this is going to work. Let me see if what screen you are seeing. Okay, so you are seeing a right screen. So I'm going to go to here and say build all. Okay, it's done, and say program. So moment of truth. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on a full screen. I don't know what it is doing. Oh, I don't know what it is doing. Okay, let's put it on full screen. Okay, come on. Bootloader error. Let's save this file. Save. Okay, not save as save. Okay, file. Save all. Okay, I don't know why this has happened. Let me disconnect this and let me connect it back. Okay, let's look at the configure portion. Configure portion. I don't see a reason for this not working. Oh, seems like. Okay, so what I'll do here is the following. I'm going to close this code vision and open it again. It's doing something, right? Okay, let's see if I can program this. Project, build all, and program chip. Let's see if this goes up. It did go off. Let's see if it is incrementing or decrementing. Okay, so it does. Okay, so let me put you on the, let's see if you are on the full screen. So let me put you on the full screen. So you can see the code here, right? So let me put you on the full screen. Okay, so now I am doing increment here, you see? So this is 10 or A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E, this is F, and this is 1, 0, 1, 1, okay, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7, 1, 8, 1, 9, 1, A, 1, B, 1, C, 1, D, 1, E, 1, F, and then 2, 0. Now let's go back, decrement. 2, 0 will become 1, F, 1, F, 1 E, 1 D, 1 C, 1 B, 1 A, 9, 1 9, 1 8, 1 7, 1 6, 1 5, 1 4, 1 3, 1 2, 1 1, 1 0, and then that's going to be F, E, D, oh, sometimes it's doing twice. This is going to be your 1011, that is B, A, then this is 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, so I have implemented the same functionality using pin change interrupt. So this is far more cleaner. This is not polling the bins, the bits on port B. This is waiting for the interrupt, right? The interrupt, what is inside the while loop is just enforcing this on port D for the display to the 8 bits here. Okay, port D 8 bits, it's going to display on these LEDs, right? So it is enforcing whatever is stored on disk. But as far as updating the disk or that variable disk, it is going to the interrupt to do that. So this is far cleaner, this is much better management of resource. So whenever you do work with something, don't rely on polling, okay? Second thing is, whenever you use polling to create delay, like, you know, all the Arduino designers, they are used to this delay underscore MS and then put a delay and then they say, okay, now it's working. No. It's not going to be accurate according to me. I don't know how it is implemented inside, right? So the way I would do it, so let's say if I'm running a clock, for example, and the clock has to be updated every second, then I will have a timer issuing an interrupt every second to update the clock, right? So one of the interrupts is going to be real time, and that is going to mask all the interrupts. So whenever an interrupt is issued, it basically masks all the interrupts. Okay, so there is no priority in terms of, there is no nesting in terms of interrupts here, unless you physically go and enable the global interrupt inside the routine. So if you don't do that, what's going to happen is whenever the interrupt comes in, okay, all the interrupts are blocked unless that interrupt is served. So this is not nested in any way. But then it is has a priority because it is a vector. So because it is a vector, then the ones which are the lower numbers in this table, they have a higher interrupt, higher priority than the ones which are higher in number, which has lower priority. So now you understand that this interrupts are not nested unless you mechanically do it. Okay. And then, like in ARM, you will see a nested interrupt vector controller, NVIC vector interrupt controller, right? Which you do not see here. Okay, so that basically is a very small tutorial on GPIO. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to put here on the analog pins. I'm going to put here a pot, and I will put here a display. And I want to read the pot and display it on the display here, right? So I can take the measurement of the pot to a display. So this is what next, in the next session I'm going to do. Okay, so thanks a lot. Thank you very much.